Hi Pisces, this is your March 22nd through March 28th weekly tarot reading. I do 5 separate spreads in my weekly readings. We'll have a spread on new love, a separate spread on love in an existing relationship. I'll do an X spread. We'll talk about your work, your business, and your finances, and we'll see what you're not expecting to happen this week. Please like, subscribe, and donate to support this channel. This first spread is on new love. This week, we have the Five of Pentacles, we have the World, we have Strength, clarified by the Ace of Pentacles. In the potential outcome, we have the Ace of Wands, clarified by the Four of Wands and the Wheel of Fortune. And we also have the Empress on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Leo or pretty much anybody, because this is a general reading. So I think right now you feel left out in the cold. And it could be due to a recent breakup or not so recent breakup. Something is just not going well in your life right now. Like I said, it could be anything. It could be a family situation. It could be the fact that you just can't find the right person for a while. Or, like I said, you could have broken up recently with somebody. But the good news is that it's coming to an end. Let's take a closer look. We have the Five of Pentacles, the first card that came out. This is a card of somebody feeling left out in the cold. This is a card of somebody feeling miserable. So that is your current energy, Pisces. Right? Perhaps you think that you'll never find the right person. You'll never fall in love again. And it could be due to a variety of reasons. The ones I've just mentioned could be just some of them. I don't know exactly what's happening in your life. But this is the way you're feeling right now. But the good news is that all of that is about to become a thing of the past. The next card that came out is the World card. The World is my happy end card. So one chapter of your life is about to end and the new happy chapter of your life is about to begin. Then we have Strength. Strength is the personal Leo card. So you could be dealing with a Leo. Or Strength is you actually having courage to get out there, or you having courage to start dating again, or Strength is pure, raw passion. And that's clarified by the Ace of Pentacles. So the Ace of Pentacles is a golden opportunity. By the way, we have two aces in the spread. The Ace of Pentacles could be a proposal at some point in the future. This person coming into your life will change your life forever. With this Ace of Pentacles. If you take a closer look at the Ace of Pentacles, there is a pathway in the right bottom corner. So that's the pathway to new life. This person will help you get out of this hole, and they will change your life forever, right? Strength could be about you just having strength to overcome what was happening in your life. Or it could be a Leo. We also have the Empress on the bottom of the deck. That is probably you as well, Pisces. The Empress is abundance in its purest form. The Empress is one of the most positive cards in the deck. And whenever the Empress comes out in my spreads, it's always about a stamp of approval or a sign from above for this relationship or this connection to form or to move forward. Speaking of moving forward, in the potential outcome, we have the Ace of Wands with the Four of Wands and the Wheel of Fortune. The Wheel of Fortune is a start a new cycle. So yeah, you are moving forward. The Ace of Wands is a passionate new beginning. So it goes very nicely together with the Strength card, because Strength could also be about passion, like I said. And we also have the Four of Wands right there, sandwiched in between the Ace of Wands and the Wheel of Fortune. The Four of Wands is one of the committed relationship cards or marriage cards. Some people call it the 11-11 card. So divine timing could be at play here as well. The Wheel of Fortune could also be about the divine timing, right? To me personally, the Four of Wands is the actual wedding cards, because in some cultures when people get married they do it underneath the structure with the leaves and branches, and that is what I think we have in the Four of Wands. I know it's partially blocked, but that's what it always reminds me of, that, right? So yeah, this is a great story. This is a great reading. Yeah, I gotta give myself credit, Pisces, right? So we start off with the five of pentacles. You feeling really sad, depressed, and you're feeling left out in the cold, you're feeling miserable, but we end up in a completely different situation. with all these aces, with all these major arcana cards, with the relationship or marriage card, right? So Pisces, cheer up. Things are about to get much, much better for you. All right, cool. Pisces, if you are already married or in a relationship, this spread is for you. We have the Three of Cups, we have the Two of Cups, we have the Ten of Cups, and we also have the Nine of Cups on the bottom of the deck. Every single card on the table, as you can probably tell, is a Cups card. And it's one of the happiest spreads for this week, to be honest with you. This is a this is a spread of celebration. This is a spread of some kind of an event or a party or a gathering, a very happy type of an event. So perhaps you're celebrating something. It could be a wedding. It could be your wedding, or you could be going to someone else's wedding, or you definitely have a reason to celebrate. Something amazing is about to happen, and it will be a wish come true. Or it will definitely make you feel really, really emotionally satisfied. So the Three of Cups, this is a card of a celebration, or a card of a union, or a card of an event, or a gathering, or a party. Then the Two of Cups is one of the best cards when it comes to love. So it could be a wedding, or it could be an engagement party, or it could be some sort of a very happy celebration. It's possible that one of you got a new job or got a promotion and you're celebrating that, because the Two of Cups could symbolize a handshake, and this is when people sign paperwork, right? And we also have the Ten of Cups. The Ten of Cups is one of the best cards when it comes to emotionally fulfilling relationships or marriages. This is the happily ever after card, or happiness after hardship. And the Nine of Cups on the bottom of the deck, this is a card of a wish come true, or this is a card of a personal satisfaction. So a very, very, very emotional week for you, Pisces. I don't know what's happening, but you are going to be jumping for joy. So happy. So much happiness here. This is happiness galore. Congratulations, Pisces. Let's see if anybody comes back from the past for you, Pisces, this week. Keep in mind, it could be somebody from a couple of months ago, a year ago, or a couple of years ago. So it doesn't have to be the most recent ex. We have the Seven of Wands, clarified by the Wheel of Fortune. We have the Ten of Pentacles. We have the Eight of Cups. And we have the Lovers on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Gemini. This is an interesting spread. This person, this ex, they will be very persistent. The first card I came out is the Seven of Wands. This is a card of somebody who is on defense. So what I think this person is defending is the idea of the two of you getting back together. And they will try to prove it to you with the Seven of Wands. They will most likely list all the pros, not the cons, all the pros as to why the two of you should get back together. And like I said, they will be defending that as much as they can, right? The Seven of Wands is clarified by the Wheel of Fortune. The Wheel of Fortune in this case is a restart of a cycle between the two of you. And we also have the Ten of Pentacles right there in the middle. The Ten of Pentacles is a card of a committed relationship or marriage. So this person really wants you back. They really want this relationship back, or potentially they want to take this relationship to the next level and get married at some point in the future. The Ten of Pentacles is about stability. It's all about groundedness. It's all about practicality, right? And the Lovers on the bottom of the deck, it could be a Gemini you're dealing with. But if we want to stay general, then the Lovers is a choice. So you will have to make a choice, Pisces, as to rekindle this relationship or to walk away. The last card I came out is the Eight of Cups. This is a card of somebody walking away. So I'm going to call it 50-50. Since the Eight of Cups is the last card that came out, it's possible that you'll decide to leave this person in the dust. But for some of you, you could make a decision to give this person a second chance. All right? Cool. Let's talk about your work, your business, and your finances. Pisces, this week we have the Seven of Swords, we have the Six of Cups, we have the Five of Cups, and we have the Chariot on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with Cancer. So somebody is going to come back from the past. Somebody who stabbed you in the back. Somebody who betrayed you. Somebody who did you wrong. And I think they regret that. And I think they want to make things right with you. So the Seven of Swords, the first card that came out, this is a card of a deception. This is a card of somebody who cheated you out of your money, who stabbed you in the back, and, you know, that kind of deal. And the Six of Cups right next to it, this is a card of somebody coming back from the past. And the Five of Cups is a card of a regret. So I think they regret what they've done to you. The Chariot on the bottom of the deck, it could be a Cancer you're dealing with, but I think the Chariot is all about moving forward, moving past what happened between the two of you in the past. And I think they will do something, or they will offer you something to make things right. I don't know what it is. It could be a new job. It could be money. Perhaps they owe you money and they never paid you back. And here they come with that money. Anything. So the main point of the spread is they have a lot of regrets about what happened. And I think they're willing to make things right. All right? Cool. Let's see what you're not expecting to happen this week, Pisces. We have the Chariot, we have Justice, we have the Ace of Wands, and we have the Page of Wands on the bottom of the deck. You could be dealing with a Cancer or a Libra. It kind of reminds me of the work, business, and finances spread I did for you a few minutes ago. We also had the Chariot in that spread. So it could be somebody reaching out from the past, making you some kind of an offer to make things right. Or it could be about something completely different. There is an offer on the table, literally, right? Because we got the Ace of Wands and the Page of Wands. The Ace of Wands is that new offer, new passionate offer. The spread could be about work, business, and finances. It could be about love as well. If this is about love, then I would be careful, Pisces, because there's lots of fire here with the Ace of Wands and the Page of Wands, but there's no love. It's most likely just passion. If you just want to have some fun, Pisces, with this person, go ahead. I'm not judging. It's your life. It's whatever you want to do. But if you're thinking long-term, I don't think this person is about long-term, to be honest with you. So the Page of Wands is a message coming in. Then the Chariot is either a Cancer you're dealing with, or the Chariot is moving forward, moving towards something. The Chariot could also be an invitation to go together on a weekend getaway trip and have some fun, right? Or the Chariot with the Justice card, this is them wanting to make things right by offering you something. And that is connected to the work, business, and finances spread. And Justice could be a Libra, by the way, because this is the personal Libra card. Or Justice is you needing to make a decision in regards to this offer. Now that you know that this person just wants to have some fun, if this is about love, then you'll have to make a just decision. And like I said, if you want to have some fun, then go ahead. But if you want something long-term, then this person is probably not for you. All right, Pisces, so that's what I got for you for this week. If it resonates, please like this video. And other than that, have an amazing week. And there you have it. This was your tarot reading for this time period. I hope it resonated with you and helps you live a better life one way or the other. Thank you for watching, sharing, and subscribing.